A message to the girls from the boys.
What the hell is up, girls? It's your boys, Aiden
and Kurt. Tonight's the best night of your life, prom. Or at least, it was.
We should be in a hotel ballroom right now, making you feel like a queen.
But unfortunately for Cupid, prom got canceled because of the Cordoba virus.
Since we can't be there to shower you in admirances, we thought we'd take you to prom in your fantasy.
And tell you what would have gone down if we were there to put it down.
6 p.m.
Pictures?
First up, I would show up 30 minutes early with my entire family.
I will present you with a refrigerated corsage made entirely of 100% baby's breath. That's the breath of a baby, girl.
I will rent a tux from a Halloween website.
We could take 3,000 pictures next to your neighbor's fancy shrub, and my hands, they're gonna sweat so much that the back of your dress is gonna change color, girl.
6:45.
Limo time!
I will pay for my whole portion of limo and half of yours.
I, of course, will sit up front where there is a seatbelt, and I will chat with the driver. It seems like it would be hard to drive around the corners with the limo.
7:23.
We enter the dance.
You walk off to be with and talk to girls. I will be with my guys. Twice through the night, I will approach you and then leave.
Mr. Chapman said we'd make a great pair. I don't know if you heard that, but it's actually something to think about.
Our promise at the Aviation Museum. I was actually on the committee that helps select the theme. World War II.
And ooh, girl, if we were at prom, we'd dance like this.
And like this.
Probably some of this.
And of course, this.
10:15.
Makeup time.
When it's time to kiss, I will become distant and sweaty, like a first-time bank robber.
I will have so many Altoids throughout the night, you will feel my breath in your eyes.
I will close my eyes and fully miss your mouth.
I'll start things off easy by sucking your tongue just the way you like it, girl.
At the end of the night, I will pay my friend Chris to give me a hickey.
I can't wait to take you home to your house. And then I, of course, will go to my house and explode. I love you, Bridget.